Hey, welcome to my software journal. My name is Ronald, and today we're going to be talking about how can you get your first software engineering job. So let's get into it. This video is for anyone who's trying to do software engineering. They don't really have no experience at all. And I mean, you could have a CS degree or no CS degree. Pretty much this is gonna jumpstart you getting your first software engineering job. So let's get into it. So the first thing you gotta do right now is start coding. So start coding now, and that's the only way you're really gonna get into it. Start building these projects. Projects are really good, especially if they're in depth on the technologies that you're working on and that you wanna work on. So build projects that are interesting to you and get comfortable of being uncomfortable, because as you continue to build these projects, they're gonna build up your confidence level, build up your confidence level on anything or technology that you're particularly working on. So if you really wanna, you know, work on your CSS and stuff that I'm currently working on right now to get more proficient in my front-end technologies and front-end development, work on those projects that are going to be specifically honed to your personal skills. I'll be building projects periodically on my channel, so you know, subscribe to this channel so you can be more updated on the videos I'm doing. So whenever those projects do come out, you can follow along, build them to your portfolio, and you know, get the software engineering job that you want. I got a lot of my initial work and projects from building apps and websites for other clients. And pretty much this allowed me to, you know, get those skills that I needed to work on anything that I need to possibly work on as I go to the next level or go to a job that will allow me to use those technologies. So when you're building these projects, it's really gonna help out your problem solving skills, because I mean, at the end of the day, you might, you know, scope it out and you know what technologies that you need to use, but at the end of the day, it's all about implementation and execution. So you gotta implement the plan, and you gotta follow through and execute the plan in order to get to the final product. So these projects are gonna really help you with that execution. And like I said, it's gonna build your confidence. You're gonna build your confidence when you're building these applications. So make sure you get started now. And like I said, subscribe to this channel because I will be doing projects periodically. All right, so the next part of that, after you build your projects, then you have content for your resume. So the next part is making a one-page resume. Because nowadays, with people's short attention spans and everything, you need to have a one-page resume that fits all the skill sets that you can possibly think of that will fit the position that you're applying for. And this is a good transition over. Know what role that you're applying for. So I did a video on the different types of software engineering. So front end, back end, full stack, infrastructure, security, and testing. So know what role that you want to play in the company that you want to go to as a software engineer, and pretty much tailor your resume for that company. A lot of mistakes that happen with a lot of resumes is that people put irrelevant stuff on their resumes. You might know SQL or something like that, but do you really need to know SQL for front-end development? Probably not. If it's something that might be relevant, like such as a full-stack engineer, then yeah, you can put SQL there because you would be handling the back-end aspects of the application and also the front-end aspects of the application. So putting SQL will make sense. I'm gonna have a video on how to structure your resume, and pretty much what you need to have on your resume pretty much breaks down in this: your name, email, work experience, projects, education and certifications and training. Education, certification and training pretty much should fit on the same line. So you have your, you know, school that you went to. If you didn't go to the school, if you got certifications, put it there. If you don't have any education at all, you don't really need it, take it out. But if you have projects and work experience, then that's something that you can put on your resume. And I'm gonna be explaining that in another video because it gets really in detail. All right, so you got your resume put together and everything. Now the next part is a number game. You gotta start applying to jobs. When you're applying to jobs, think about this. If you're coming from no experience at all, but you have projects underneath your belt that you built, and they look pretty impressive, and they pretty much show a wide span of your technical ability, you can, you know, put that resume on there and look at the entry level of that position, and also do a lot of research on that position in your area, because you never want to be undercutted for the job or the work that you're doing. Because a lot of people might give you $30,000 for a job that might be actually $50K in that particular area. So make sure you do the research on the salaries that you're applying for, and never really underestimate your skill set. If you are coming in at entry level, make sure that you go for a job that's actually going to teach you and is going to provide you opportunity to learn and grow with that company for the next 2 to 5 years. Because that's really important if you stick with a company that's going to coach you through the abilities, because companies, for the most part, even with CS degrees that come into this industry as a software engineer, they sometimes don't even have the experience of coding, but the companies are more lenient with people who actually have the education, and they probably have exposure to coding. They have more lenience, and they will be willing to coach those individuals to get to the level of expertise that they need to get. Keep that in mind when you're looking at a company. Make sure you get into that headspace of growing and going to the next level. This can vary quite widely from person to person. You might actually looking for skills, you might be looking for salary. Just know why you're going for that particular position and know your exit plan when you get in there. Because if you're just going for the experience, then the salary might not be as much as important, but the company is providing you the opportunity to grow, then go for that experience. And then as you get the experience that you need, negotiate your salary as you gain more expertise in your particular area, or go to another company that will pay you more. Generally, that's something that you might have to do. Make sure you apply to the jobs in a rapid kind of space, because at the same time, it's a numbers game. It's a matter of how many resumes can you actually put out there to get a call back. Put out 100, then you're gonna get 10% out of it, whatever. Use Indeed or ZipRecruiter, and use like those different like things where you go through Indeed and they allow you to rapidly apply. The only thing you have to put in is your email and a resume. I did this so many different times to get the jobs that I need to get as a software engineer, and it's been proved so effective. So for the most part, after you apply to those applications, make sure you keep learning. Continue to learn, especially this is mainly for those entry-level people who are coming in. Continue to learn the basics. Know the basics of the OOP language, of a single language. So if it's Java that you're really trying to master, know how to implement OOP concepts with that Java language. And then another thing too, know the control flows of that language and the syntax of that language in and out. This could be really effective for those particular jobs that you're doing a lot of back-end technology implementation. Once you learn one language, you pretty much know the basis of all languages, because a lot of languages nowadays, they follow that concept of OOP concepts. And because you're a software engineering, you, like I said, it depends on what area or role you're looking into. Learn how to provision a database, learn how to provision a server, know the difference between the different databases such as relational and NoSQL databases. Further on, learn how to data model, because there's so many different ways to data model your objects and how you're gonna be storing your data. It comes in so many different words, but I believe data modeling is probably the best way I understand it, because you're actually modeling how your data should be stored and how it will be relational with other data in the database. Learn about how to implement APIs on your servers. So there's two main concepts out there, SOAP and REST. Mainly the main one currently, as today's standards are, is REST. And the old standard is probably like SOAP. So look into those different ways of how to implement APIs in a SOAP aspect and a REST aspect. Lastly, learn about the different platforms that you need to learn that will be, you know, using your application. There's desktop, there's web, there's tablets, there's mobile. There's so many different platforms that you can use to access an application. So learn about the different platforms that will be utilizing the different applications for that company. You'll be golden. And then the last part of this is the interview. So up to this point, I'm telling you right now, if you do everything like I said, you'll be ready for the interview in and out. How to provision a database. You're gonna know the different types of the databases that you need to learn, the pros and the cons of those databases, and when they should be implemented. When those questions come up in the interview, you're like, I did it. And another thing too, when you're interviewing with a particular company, if you don't know something right away, it's like, I don't really know that in particular aspect of that technology, or I haven't dealt with that yet, but I am willing to learn about that particular technology and that different aspects of how to implement that. And I could probably definitely get back to you on how to implement that for sure. Whenever you like come across questions like that where you don't know, just tell them straight up. And don't be too quick about answering questions. All right, let me think about that really quick. When you're doing interviews, there's sometimes you have questions that will give you a context of, like, for instance, behavior type questions. Give them a context, give them an action that you did, and give it the results of that action to resolve that issue. Pretty much car. That's pretty much all what you need to learn in order to get your first software engineering job. I wish I would have known this information when I first started off in this career. And actually, I got a lot of guidance from my mentor, what I needed to do in order to get my first tech job. So I appreciate you, Morel, if you're out there watching my videos. I appreciate you for, you know, guiding me through that process of understanding how to actually do a tech interview and setting up my resume and so on. So thank you very much for your guidance and wisdom. And like I said, I'm only just trying to pass on this wisdom to other people. So if you want to continue to vibe with me, continue to see this content, subscribe to this channel, and, you know, until next time, peace.